Howdy, Banger fans. Blaine Smith welcoming you back to Overkill Reviews, Banger's weekly battle review show. But this is a patron's pick edition. What does that mean? Well, it's you picking the record this time. If you support us on Patreon, you know, you get to pick a record maybe we missed, we didn't talk about. You're like, I want to hear what the boys and the gals and the everybody's at Banger think about it. Let's talk about it. So that's what we're doing here, and let's hear what we're talking about. Surprised that we couldn't talk about this as you are. There's too many releases. It's been a crazy year for metal, considering it's a pandemic. Where are all these albums coming from? But this album is coming from Relapse Records and the boys in Wolves in the Throne Room. It's called Primordial Arcana. It came out August 20th, and it's a little past August 20th, but better late than never. Formed in 2002 in Washington, Wolves in the Throne Room became sort of a standard bearer for a new wave of American black metal made predominantly by people that notably aren't bigots and what ain't never done a murder. Woo, black metal. At its core, Wolves in the Throne Room has always been the Weaver Brothers, though in 2017 they added longtime live guitarist Cody Keyworth to the official lineup. They released four very celebrated albums, and you know what, since Sarah moved to Finland, you know, someone's got a Sarah in here, so here they are. There we go. They released four very, very important albums. You know, they like wolves, they like throne rooms, they like the forest. And then after the four albums, they released another album that was, let's just say mostly bad. Whoops. Not very black metal, though totally not in the kind of like Illid, Divinum, Insanum misstep. They realized that people weren't super stoked on it. They returned to black metal for the next release, and then here we are for another release that is also, thankfully, a black metal album. Yay. Continuing things that I'm thankful for is that we get into some black metal real quick on the record. There's sort of an intro to Mountain Magic, but it's like a found sound layering effect that turns into music and brings in a nice cold riff. So that's okay with me. That's how you do an intro track properly. And of course, the black metal on display here is definitely up to Wolves in the Throne Room standard. Riffs nail the cold, foresty, atmospheric feel that they're famous for. Through Eternal Fields, starts slow and just sounds good and really brings me back to that nice, slow kind of head nod era Wolves in the Throne Room. It's a shame it doesn't hold on to that part for as long as I'd like it to, but I'm still happy about it as a sound. I like the way it sounds in my ears, so I'm talking about it here instead of down in the bad. I have a similar thing happen on Master of Rain and Storms. It has some really big evil energy and I get really stoked, but unfortunately it kind of makes up a minority of the song, but it's still there. It still adds a nice flavor to it. Let's hear that flavor. Right? That sounds really evil, you know? It'd be very cool to see these guys do a kind of take on a big evil Satan style black metal record, even if it was under a different name, a different project, if you will. As always, I do have to give a massive tip of the hat, a nod to Aaron Weaver's great sounding drums. No matter what he's playing, it sounds great, whether he's marching or blasting along. He's a really great emotive drummer. You really feel him come through, and because they're the ones making the record sound the way it is, both in the playing and the production, they sound really good, especially the cymbals. You know, when drums sound really good, boy, do they sound really good and not like a weird robot. Wouldn't change a thing. There are a variety of synths on the album. Of course, you know, these boys have a big collection. Some I like, less. Some I really dig, though. Underworld Aurora has a great sound that you can hear, well, here. Like they captured a variant John Carpenter who decided to make nature documentaries instead of sci-fi, which is to say, they sound very good and very appropriate for the woods. Other times I do find them snapping me out of the atmosphere a bit because the synths can sometimes sound a little too clear and sharp and not atmospheric. It's definitely, you know, symphonic black metal influenced a little bit, like towards the end of Master of Rain and Storm. And there's been some negatives mixed in here, so I'm just gonna move on to the negatives. The issue Wolves in the Throne Room face at this point is it's now been 15 years since their first release, and their magical sound has actually inspired a whole wave of black metal musicians who've experimented, altered, and carried it on. They've had an amazing impact on black metal, but they're still Wolves in the Throne Room, and on my personal journey with them, they've gone from, you know, a backpatch band to, you know, a reminiscent listen. Diet on the 12 Stars came out when I was 20 and absolutely shaped my musical journey, but here I am as a 35-year-old man, and I've taken in an amount of black metal that I think any medical professional would describe as a worrisome. And I kind of want them to elevate what they're doing, you know? These are pioneers. Pioneer. Compared to something like my Panopticon review recently, I still do not have enough of Panopticon sound in my life, so a new Panopticon record doesn't need to stray from the formula quite yet, but with Witter, we have a ton of Witter-esque bands and records and stuff. And so I'm good on this, and I think they have it in them to do more as well. This record can feel a bit like they're trying to fit their whole career, their whole sound in there, like a retrospective, a greatest hit. So the result is my favorite parts, this stuff that sounds really good, that they make really good, wind up short, like I've mentioned a couple of times earlier with the stuff I liked and then complaining that it wasn't there for longer. I would really love it if maybe they gotta get, you know, start venturing out, exploring a bit more, meet some people. You guys are locked up in the woods. Get some collabs going. Wolves in the Throne Room, Austin Lund collab, come on. Or as I said, maybe work with one of these evil guys. You know, Satan and the forest go together. And I get you love your woods, but you know, I don't know. Why don't we maybe go on a vacation? Get out there. Give me some desert desolation, some tropical turmoil, some yurt hurt. I think your mileage on this record is going to be heavily dependent on how you self-identify. If you're a Wolves in the Throne Room first, you'll be ecstatic that the boyos are back to form. This is a really good sounding Wolves in the Throne Room record. If you're a black metal fan first, though, yeah, I think you'll be a little more. There's been some amazing black metal these past few years, especially in the atmospheric space, especially this year. And while everything on the record is very well done, it does feel like these brave pioneers that I've been speaking of have stopped trekking through the woods so much. You know, they've maybe chopped down some trees, built a clearing. You know, the rough log house has become a settlement. And, you know, I still want to be out here in the woods getting bit by things that I don't know what they are. And that's why I'm giving the record 3.5 out of 5 of those desert, you know, cow skulls, because I'm tired of this damn forest. What did you think about the album? I know you wanted us to talk about it. Are you happy that I talked about it this way? Are you mad? Are you sad? Are you glad? I don't know. Let me know in the comments below. I'll get down there in the mix with you. We can chat about our favorite Wolves memories. And, you know, just subscribe to us on Patreon. Please. And hi, I have a Twitch channel. We can talk about this more. Come on over to Twitch, twitch.tv/mentalcomedy. This Sunday, I'm doing my mental monthly research stream. Come by, please. But before you go, I was saying that there's a bunch of amazing black metal, and here I'm just gonna serve you up a platter of a bunch of amazing black metal. And if you're a Patreon subscriber, this part will be longer. There's gonna be more bands I talk about in here. Look at that, it's what you all want. Just more bands, more bands. How about some Chernobyl concept album black metal? Crystal Coffin, The Stairway Eternal. I told you, I wanna get diversity in the inspiration. Speaking of diversity in the inspiration, how about traditional European mining techniques, Douthas, Vom Schmort Schritten. What? I don't know, man. It's mining black metal. Mining black metal. If you really want to stick around in the forest, don't worry. Here's some more forest for you. Can Bard Devoured by the Oak. Oak's a tree. It's in the forest. And hey, I just want to close this out by, giving a little nod to a little black metal EP about The Witcher made by a vampire. It's Hexelblad, The Fall of Sintra. Please check that out. And please hang out with us. Thanks. Bye-bye.